Welcome to Party Animal Quilting. In last week's episode, I stitched ribbon candy in a contrasting color and in a matching color and did some echoing. I said I was going to take some time to think, and I did. And what I think is, I don't like the corners. I knew last week that I didn't, but I thought I could live with them. I can't. So tonight I'm going to show you how I take this out, how I take out the corner that I didn't like and this corner that I didn't like, how I secure my knots, and my plan for restitching it. Follow along. The time has come. I'm going to pick out this corner and this corner. As I was editing the video from last week, I realized I didn't like it and that I had a better way to do it. I knew what design I wanted to do. So I'm going to pick it out to a convenient point about here, and then I'm going to pick it out to a convenient point about here. So I thought I'd talk to you about how I pick out the stitches. I use some traditional tools and some non-traditional tools. I use a seam ripper, pretty basic, but I more often use a pair of scissors and a corsage pin. This is actually a pin I use to attach my quilt to my long arm. So it's a big, thick, heavy pin, but the reason this is better for picking than a seam ripper is that this has a blade in here, and I don't always want to cut the thread. I want to have long tails on my bobbin and top thread so I can tie them and bury them so that the knots don't show whenever I join my threads together. I want to make sure that 1, 2, 3, 4 thread breaks and restarts don't scream at me from across the quilt. So let's see, I'll just mark this here that I'm going to stop picking the line out around here. That's my stopping place. So I can actually pick the stitches out from here. Let me reach in and cut one. It's kind of a big seam ripper. There we go. So I've cut a stitch. Since these are long arm pins, I have an unending supply of them. And I am going to pick this out. And it doesn't have to be one stitch at a time. After I get enough that I can grab the bobbin thread, I don't know if you can see this. I think you can. I can snip that and pull. And then I can snip and pull until I get to a length. There we go. So this goes faster than you might expect it to. I'm not really picking out one stitch at a time. It's a stitch and cut. And these are the new scissors from Handy Quilter. I just got them and they have this great point for picking and nice and sharp. So it's like two seam rippers together that you can snip. Yeah, it's got that fine point, finer point than my seam ripper does actually. So now from about here on, I don't want to break the thread. I want to flick it out like this because I want to leave long enough tails to tie. And I want to stop in a point. It's important for me to stop in a point because whenever I restart and I have to have a little bit of a knot there, if it's going to show at all, it will just look like it. Oh, I lost you. Sorry. It'll just look like it does here. Just as in an extra stitch in the point. So I'm going to pick it back to this point. That pin is bent. Let me get a straight one. There we go. Almost done with this one. Okay, so that is pulled out, unstitched, and I have my tails. So I have my bobbin thread and my top thread. And I'm going to tie these in a knot, a simple overhand, a simple left over right and under, right over left and under square knot. And I'm going to get that knot pulled down into the fabric as much as possible and tie another knot. Uh, then I'm going to grab a needle. And it doesn't even have to be particularly sharp. What I'm looking for is a bigger eye. Yeah, this is the one I typically use. This is just my random needles I find. Thread these through this big eye. I believe this is like a needlepoint needle or something. There's one. There we go. So both threads are through the eye of the needle. And now I'm going to take that needle right into the point where that stitch is and put it between the layers of the quilt. And pull it under. So that's pretty invisible here. And I'm going to trim those ends. I'm going to do that three more times here. So the echo on here, the ribbon candy over here, and the ribbon candy over here, and make all of my knots. I am going to probably end the ribbon candy close to the vine, wherever it looks like I can get a good knot, a good discrete knot. But what I'm not going to do is knot, 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 straighten a line, because if anything shows, I don't want it to grab your eye. So I have my wireless headphones. I have a book on audio from the library. I am going to plug in, listen to it, and pick stitches for a while. I'll be back to show you the next step. I have picked out my corners, this one as well as this one, and secured them with knots nice and invisibly. And I've put in some chalk lines for where I want the quilting to go. When I thought of the ribbon candy in contrasting color along the appliqué vine, I thought of it like feathers on a vine, and I was picturing it hugging the vine, so it had to go around the corner. When I was looking at it on the wall and while I was editing, what I realized is the feathers, the ribbon candy fake feathers, need to follow the applique line. So I'm pulling this row of ribbon candy out here. And let me show you how I restart this. So I'll start here. And I have long tails. So I have a long bobbin tail and a long top tail. I'm using my hand on my wheel to bring the needle down where I want it, which is right over top of the previous stitch. And back up. Pull up the bobbin thread, and I'm just going to hold these out of the way. I am now going to continue the ribbon candy stitching, but I have a little bit of echoing left over here, so I'm going to try to be sure to get my first lobe of ribbon candy out inside of that echo, and otherwise I'm just trying to stay within the chalk lines. So holding the tail so that it doesn't suck the thread back under the bottom of the quilt. Okay, I'm gonna raise my foot because I've quilted other things since this. Between the appliques here, I felt some resistance. Let's put that down just a little bit. So I finished that first line of stitching. I have to hand tie this knot and repeat the same thing out here. I need long tails for everything, so I've got to cut the threads carefully instead of just using my scissor button. So let's come up. And again, with my hand on the wheel, put that needle right where I want it. Bring up the bobbin thread and pull it to the side. I'll deal with that later. start stitching and echoing as I did before. Oh. I'm going to cut those tails down here. They don't need to be long. So once I bury these threads, hopefully you're not going to see the difference. Hopefully you're not going to see the starts and stops there. And hopefully I'm going to be much happier with the design I chose this time. Okay, do the same thing over on the other side. Bring that needle down by hand. So I have these two rows here of ribbon candy touching each other, and I'm fine with that. That chalk marker will go away, and I like that design there. What I'm going to do is echo around in here and continue the echo out here. I don't know what I'm going to do to fill in here, so I can decide that later. And back to the echo here. With my hand, needle down. I do not like what I just did. I should have looped right back up. So I'm going to cut this out, and that'll come out quickly because there's no knot at the end. Okay, let's try again. So I'm going to do the same thing, but it's going to be a really short echo here. Here, I'll just stitch over and echo back up and in. So that's done. So far, four knots I have to make yet. They don't take very long. I know some people save those for the evening, but I'm into immediate gratification. I want to see this finished, so I'm going to finish these knots very soon. Okay, so here we are in the center of the vine. Whenever I came up, I tried to make this a corner, and what I realized was when I quilt ribbon candy in blocks, I never go around the corner. So if I were to stitch ribbon candy in this border here, I would stitch ribbon candy straight all the way to the end, and then I would stitch ribbon candy straight down here. I quilt with the piecing. So I decided to do the same thing here. My vine here overlaps this vine, so I am going to quilt ribbon candy straight up to the edge here, and then I'll come and pick it up here. I might have to do it with two thread breaks. Okay, needle down by hand. Hold those tails. And again, I'm going to try to get the ribbon candy lobes into the echoing that I left in place here. There we go. And now I'm going to try to do some short ribbon candy off into this corner. Leave a long tail. It's a little uncomfortable here. I would normally have started here and gone down, but I want to match that, so that's the most important place. If I miss it, you will notice. And again, I have to get the lobes in the echoing, so I didn't have to take out that line. Trying to get a hold on those threads. They don't want to hold on. Okay. And I'm going to take this all the way down to the vine. And I'm going to do a machine knot there, so no need to leave a long tail. So far, do we like this better? I think I do. What I'm going to do now is tie the knots and hang it up. And sometimes I need to get a little further than 6 or 7 inches away to see if I really like it. So I'm going to tie and bury these knots as I've done before, hang it up, and then we'll take a look at it. I like this much better. I'm going to leave it hanging up on the wall and decide what to do next. I think I'm going to do the background quilting around the dots, and I'll have some time to decide and be back next week. Hi, I'm Debbie Brown with DebbieBrownQuilts.com, and I'm inviting you to join me on a scrap quilting adventure. Go to DebbieBrownQuilts.com. Sign up for the Color Blocks Quilt Along. Each month of 2021, I will release a different scrap quilt pattern, but it's not too early to sign up now. Soon, I'll be posting information on how to dig into your scraps, cut them up, and prepare for our 2021 adventure. While you're visiting DebbieBrownQuilts.com, don't forget to sign up for my newsletter so you don't miss any other quilty news.